Hello students, a very good morning to all. I welcome you in Social Science online class. Students, as you all know that we have started chapter 1, what, how and when in our previous class. So today I am continuing this chapter. Literary sources. What are the literary sources? Literary sources are the information gathered in written forms. Okay, they may be in letters and symbols, and these letters and symbols together form words and sentences. They use various types of scripts. Our knowledge of history is largely based on written records. When written records will be there and we will read them, then only our knowledge about the past will increase. Historians give us a special emphasis to written records such as books and manuscripts. Literary sources include manuscripts, stories, religious texts, biographies and accounts of foreigner travelers. Next, manuscripts. Manuscripts is a handwritten record of information. It could be in the form of letter, writing on leaves and barks of trees or scrolls. Because as you know that at that time there was no printing machine or no printed papers, some writings were printed. So they were written on this. These manuscripts help us to understand the form of scripts used in the olden times. The written material could be religious or secular. It is not compulsory that it should be religious or secular only. Now, religious literature. By word religious only, you came to know that what is religious literature. Yes, books and manuscripts that deals with religion. Okay, that referred to as religious literature. Religious literature provides information for the period between the beginning of the Aryans into India and Alexander's invasion into India. The Vedas, the epics, Ramayana and Mahabharata, the Upanishads, Bhagavad Gita, all are examples of religious literature, and these literature texts help us to understand the religious practices and beliefs and the social and economic life of that period. Secular literature. Secular literature contains all those texts that are of non-religious nature, or any literature which is not rooted in religious beliefs, practices and traditions comes in the secular literature, such as autobiographies, biographies and court chronicles. There were many writers, scholars and traders who visited India at various times and wrote about their experiences here. The accounts of these foreigner travelers form an important historical sources. They give us knowledge about the people, their lifestyle and the society at that time. Now, oral history or sources. In societies that didn't have a culture of writing, historians can uncover some of what happened in the past through oral history. Oral history refers to the record of historical information which is based on the personal experiences and opinions of the speaker. They involve the use of interviews, folk tales, songs, which have been passed down from generation to generation through word of mouth. Reconstruction of the past. As you know that historians use various sources and techniques to reconstruct the past. The use of documents, artifacts and chronicles is reconstructed. They reconstructed the history. And they help us, as a clue to understand and investigate our past. Now we come to geographical location. As you all know that our India is a very vast country, and India and its neighboring countries are also referred to as a subcontinent. Our India is bound by the Himalayas in the north and seas on the three sides. This Himalaya in the north acted as a natural barrier for the country, and it protected from the various invaders across the border as well as from the cold winds of North and Central Asia. The mountain passes along the northwest of the country also acted as a trade route, sir, through which many groups came into our country. The names that we use for our country today are India and Bharat. And the name India is derived from the Indus River that flows through the northern western part of the subcontinent. The Iranians and Greeks who came to India through the northwest around 2500 years ago referred to river Indus as Hindu or Indu. The land to the east of the Indus was called India. Bharat, as mentioned in the Rig Veda, was used for people who lived in the northwest. Okay, so there were so many names of our country, India, in the past. As you all know this also, that India is a land of rivers. There are many rivers such as Ganga, the Indus, Narmada, and many more. As the rivers watering the fertile plains provided tremendous scope for the settled life. They give people a settled life because the land near the rivers are fertile. There are many geographical differences in our India. As you know that there are 5 physical divisions also are there. And to understand this, we understand our past also. Next and final, what does history take place? Historians write about historical events and they use BC and AD. Now what does BC and AD means? BC means before Christ and AD means Anno Domini. We take the years of the birth of Jesus Christ as year 1. And the events that took place before the birth of Christ are referred to as BC or before Christ. For example, 800 BC means 800 before the birth of Christ. AD stands for Anno Domini. In the year of our Lord, events taking place after the birth of Christ are denoted by AD. For example, 1500 years after the birth of Christ is written as AD 1500. Till recently, most people use the terms BC and AD. But many historians are now using the terms BCE and CE. We use BCE before Common Era and CE or Common Era. Common Era is the beginning of a new era starting with the year 1 until the present. So students, we have completed our chapter 1. If you have any doubt or problem, you can call me. Students, I am repeating again and again that you watch the video and listen it carefully. But before watching the video, you read the chapter so that your doubts will become clear. Okay, students? So, read the chapter and complete your work in neat and clean handwriting. Okay? Thank you, students.